good afternoon, members of the press. We're quite thankful that we've been able to make it here for today's press briefing, which has been called by the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association ahead of our national women's team departure for Kingston, Jamaica to compete in the final round of CONCACAF Caribbean Women's World Cup qualifying for 2019. With me at the head table is Anton Corneal, recently appointed a caretaker coach of the women's senior team, also technical director of the FA. He's going to give an opening comment with regards to the state of the team right now and its preparations, and then we'll open the floor right away to some questions. Mr. Corneal, obviously you've taken reign of the team right now preparing for this tournament coming up, which is a qualifier for the final round of CONCACAF. Give us your sentiments at this point in time.
First, good afternoon to everyone. It's actually been putting a puzzle together in the last 2 weeks because of so many different little factors that we have to take into consideration. One, the resignation of the coach, you know, 16 days before the tournament, and then a couple of injuries that we had to deal with. One that we just found out today that Mariah Shade may not be going, so that puts another twist on it. And then we had some players that had to return to the US. Janelle Cunningham, Erin King, I think Leanna Hines. We have Gero also that's in the US. And then we have Karen Forbes, who had to return to her graduation. So we weren't able to train as much as we liked to with the full team. But the girls that were here worked well in the last 2 weeks.
Do we have an open question for Coach Corneal?
It's very difficult to say the injury itself. I don't know if it's a bruised bone, but she started back to jog on it, and I think it's gotten inflamed one more time. So it's difficult for her to run, it's painful, and it's going to be painful for her to kick the ball. So, and she's one of them. I think Rhea Belgrave also have struggled with a niggling injury in the back of her knee, and she has been doing rehab, but she would not be in a position to accompany the team at this level in the tournament right now. Of course, it's one of hope. We are going to play in a tournament. We still have a couple experienced players in the team. We have some younger players that will be pushing now to prove themselves, getting the opportunity. And we have to remember that Trinidad and Tobago is still one of the more accomplished teams in the Caribbean. And we have to go prove ourselves. As I said, it's a tournament where three teams will advance out of five. So we are hoping that we can advance first. What position on the table we advance, you know, that's up to the tournament. But once we can get through in those three teams, it gives us a chance to regroup. That's interesting. That's interesting. We could not do a lot of tactical work. We did do some theory with them, ways we'd like to defend. When we defend high up the field, we did a lot of things, putting pressure on the ball in practice. We tried to pick up the fitness level of the team with the players that are here. We did send programs to some of the players that are not here so that they can also get to a decent level of fitness. Other than that, simple things, we did a lot of things in and around the goal for goal scoring, 1v1, 2v2s, just preparing for a tournament. But not having the full team made it very difficult to do tactical work as a group. And I think a lot of that will have to be done in Jamaica.
All right, Coach, as you say, not having a full team, was the door open to players that would not currently on the squad, for example, our top scorer, Kenny Porter?
Yes, and we do expect her back. Of course, she's going to have to wait for the FIFA window, so she would probably miss the first game, but she'll be there for the other three games, so she is expected back.
Besides Kenya, anyone else been re-invited
to these sports? We have looked at, because of positions, we have looked at people that showed interest and training. Lauren would have been one of them who played before for us. And coming out of that, we have the nucleus of players that remained here with Tasha St. Louis, all the others that actually played in the Colombia trip 2 weeks ago at the CSC Games.
Go ahead.
Hi, Coach.
Hi.
Just following up from Carson's comment, would he like Bailey and Kinabolan also invited to the court?
Well, you know, I did not get any interest from them. Nobody's, you know, called and even made themselves available. So I'm going with the players that showed interest. As I said, I'm just there as a caretaker coach. So taking over from the group that was actually training, and then, of course, people that showed interest and would like to be part of it. So that's pretty much how we went about preparing this group. It's a difficult question to answer. Expertise from outside, like?
For instance, we hired a foreign coach before Jamal Shabazz. Is that a way that you see to sort of contest that?
What about expertise from here?
Well,
you know, so it may mean, you know, after this tournament we will revisit looking at a coach for this team, and you know, that's in 15 days time to see when we go through who's going to take it long term, whether it's someone from outside or someone from here. The TTFA will make that decision.
Has anyone been earmarked or been interested to say, well, hey, I want a shot at you and
job? Oh, I've had some interest. A lot of people called about it. Names I prefer not to, at this time, probably to say, because it's all been either phone calls, WhatsApp, an email, but it has to be done the official way, where it's going through the TTFA, through the executive, and come up with what's the best situation for this team.
Coach, if you are keeping any comments on Jamal Shabazz, the job he has done with the women after so many years?
You know, you have to think that Jamal has done human service. When people don't understand what it takes to coach a national team, it's easy to sit on the outside and comment. But when I come here and you look at the situation, so many players are not here, and he's putting together a team, and you don't have starting players because they are either out of the country, they're in school in the US, and these are the players that will start. Also, when you look at things like sometimes just the financial support for girls to come to practice, the type of commitment, a coach has to come up with money on afternoons, nearly every afternoon, to get some of these. It really takes a lot out of a coach. It goes past coaching. And I think Jamal has done that for years. And you have to take my hat off, because another coach might have walked away, you know, after 2-3 months. So, you know, I have to applaud him for what he has done over the years. He has made a decision to resign. And as I said, I'm only here for up to this tournament. And then after the tournament, we will see what's best to take our women football forward. I've kept him in the loop all of the time. Actually, I've worked with the team with Jamal, and we are good friends, and it's something that I would not have done without collaboration with him.
We've seen quite recently some issues from the cafe in terms of travel arrangements for teams that attend tournaments. How has the travel arrangements been for this tournament?
Very difficult. It's been very difficult. Just to get to Jamaica. Actually, to get to anywhere, it's been difficult to leave the country. So we have a group of girls that left this morning. Three girls left this morning. We have a group that's going to go on Wednesday, and then we have some that may come in on Friday. So it's been very difficult to get to Jamaica. Some had to go through Miami. Some will go directly to Jamaica.
How difficult has that been, especially in terms of the injuries that you mentioned, having to send up the different groups, or has it actually worked out to your benefit, saying that you could actually rotate certain players going in any last match?
Very difficult. Very difficult. To put a team together, you have to get the right synergy between players. And when that player keeps changing, it means in practice you have to find ways of making the most out of the players that are ready. So it means some players will have to multitask. Actually, we started it in practice, where some players, I'm not going to say will play out of position, but will have to understand the roles and functions of more than one position. You know, it's unfortunate that these are the cards dealt us, but we have to play the best game possible with these cards.
Any further questions for Coach?
This panel, when would the official squad be unveiled?
We take a look this afternoon to see which players we'll make a decision on some injuries this afternoon. They don't look good for two of them. We have made a decision on some already that just cannot play. And when that decision is made, actually we have spoken to CONCACAF 10 minutes ago to see if it's possible to include one or two other players that was actually training with the team to get them in that initial 30 players. We have that as an issue. And then some possibly players that are playing in the US with universities, if they're able to return, because the university season started a week ago. And it's difficult to ask a player to leave school, and they started just 1 week ago, for 8 to 10 days. So also that's an issue, not just for us, but probably for Antigua, if they have players playing in the US and Jamaica.
What do you think the women's program in general is most in need of players to really
It's a broad-based question, and you know, I think we need to grow the base of young ladies playing football, starting at the bottom. It's just not a big enough pool, and you know, that calls for long-term planning, and we do have plans to grow grassroots in primary schools, where we have hopefully 1,000 young girls between ages of 8 to 10, starting the game in September. We started this program in January of this year, and we need to make sure that the same numbers we have of boys playing, that we have girls playing also. Also to find ways to encourage the academies, to encourage more girls to take part in the academies. But we must grow our youth programs when it comes to women's football.
Do you have any closing questions for Coach? All right, gentlemen, thank you for attending. We invite you to stay on for the training session that follows here. And just a reminder that we...